Frolic Gladstone Rainey was an American anthropologist, a master of narrative prose. He was the type of ancient specialist anyone in the field would have relished working with. Regarding the Arctic, he put it to the National History Museum as follows, quote, "We have now found an Arctic metropolis, many times larger than anything previously thought possible in this part of the world, and once inhabited by a people whose material culture differed markedly from that of the Eskimos as we know them." He continues, "One morning in the June of 1940, when Magnus Markey and I had returned to begin the second season of digging at Iputak, we soon became aware of the astonishing extent of these ruins. We could see long avenues of yellow squares, marking the ancient buildings, spanning east and west for well over a mile. Over the next several days, we hurriedly attempted to chart these ruins before they all became hidden once more. We eventually realized that more than 600 buildings would have once stood on this ancient site, a site well over a mile in length." End quote. Dated at many thousands of years old, you have to wonder, why is not more publicity shared regarding these mysterious people? Sophisticated objects have been unearthed, which demonstrate a far more complex civilization than the proto-Eskimo culture academia would have you believe inhabited the area. The architectural abilities of this mysterious group also far exceeds the capabilities of other ancient cultures, even as far as Mexico. The largest ancient settlement ever found to have existed in Alaska, it was even bigger than any Arctic coastal village in Alaska or Canada today. The town of Iputak would have once been home to more than 8,000 people. Just who were the Iputak people? How did they survive so successfully within an Arctic climate many thousands of years ago? Are we looking at a culture far older than we are told? Regardless, one reason to conceal such a fact would be the Bering Strait hypothesis, a hypothesis conveniently crucial to evolution theory, and one which numerous people have lost their careers over. Dr. Scott Elias at the Colorado Institute of Arctic and Alpine Research, quote, "As far as Orthodox scholarship is concerned, the validity of the Bering land bridge route is not up for debate. Regardless of such cult rhetoric, the Iputak people are certainly an interesting and controversial bunch, and worthy of future study. We will keep you posted."